Students, today I am going to discuss the male repeat part of plant Antirrhinum. In that development of anther, I am going to explain you now. A flower possesses four holes: calyx, corolla, Antirrhinum, and gynœcium. Now I show you this. This is the calyx, and this is corolla. And this is the male reproductive part. These stamens are the male reproductive part, Antirrhinum, and this one is the gynœcium, female reproductive part. This I will explain you later. Today the topic is Antirrhinum, that is the male reproductive part. Here this is the stamen. The stamen consists of a filament and the anther. This region is the anther and this is the filament. This anther possesses pollen grains. How these pollen grains develop in this anther only, I am going to explain you today. Each stamen possesses an anther. Anther and a filament. This is stamen. In this anther only the pollen grains are present, developed here, and it is present here in this anther only. Development of anther. A very young anther develops as a homogeneous mass of tissue like this. And surrounded by an epidermis. Surrounded by epidermis. During development, it will become a four-lobed structure like this. It will become a four-lobed structure. In each lobe, a row or few rows of cell. This is epidermis, and below this, a row or few rows of hypodermal cells. These are hypodermal cells. Hypodermal cells becomes enlarged with clear nuclei. It will become enlarged with clear nuclei. This function as archisporium. Below the epidermis, hypodermal cells are there. This acts as archisporium. The archisporial cells divide by periclinal divisions like this. One layer, two layer, three layers like this. Periclinal divisions like this. Periclinal divisions to form primary parietal cells. This is called primary parietal cells towards the epidermis. Parietal cells towards the epidermis. And primary sporogenous tissues, that is cells, towards the inner side of the anther. Once again I explain you. Below the epidermis, a row or few rows of cells undergoes periclinal divisions, and it will become enlarged, and it will become hypodermal cells, and this is also called archisporium, and which is developed towards the epidermis. This is called the parietal cells, and the primary sporogenous cells towards the inside. See here, towards inside of the anther. The primary parietal cells undergo a series of periclinal and anticlinal divisions. Periclinal means number of divisions like this. Anticlinal means like this. So it will be going on developing like this. Periclinal means like this. It is going on dividing like this. Anticlinal means this number of this also will be increasing like this. So both the divisions happen here and forms 2 to 5 layer of anther walls. It will become anther walls. 2 to 5 layers of anther walls. This anther wall composed of endothecium, middle layer and tapetum. See here, below this epidermis endothecium is there, and below this, see here, middle layers are there, and after the middle layer and the tapetum, the inner side is, it is called tapetum, this one. So from the outside epidermis and the endothecium, and here the middle layer, and this one is called the tapetum. From the periphery to the center, epidermis, and this is endothecium, middle layers and the tapetum. Once again I'll tell you, epidermis, and this is the endothecium. See here, this layer is endothecium and this is middle layer. These are the middle layer cells, and inside this is called the tapetum. See, this layer is called the tapetum. So epidermis and this endothecium, middle layers and the tapetum. Now we are going to see the microsporogenesis, that is development of pollen grains. We are going to see the stages involved in the formation of haploid microspore from the diploid microspore mother cell through the meiosis is called microsporogenesis. From the formation of haploid microspores from the diploid microspore mother cell to haploid microspores is called, through meiosis it is developed, that is the reduction division. This is called the microsporogenesis. The primary sporogenous tissue undergoes mitotic division to form sporogenous tissue. The last generation of sporogenous tissue develops into microspore mother cell. This undergoes meiotic division. Here only reduction division starts and forms microspores. See, microspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division to form microspores. And each microspore mother cell divides meiotically to form a tetrad. Tetrad means four. Four haploid microspores. And these microspores soon separate from each other and remain free in anther locule and develop into pollen grains. These are finally, it will become pollen grains. See here, four lobed structure. These are the sporogenous cells. These cells undergo mitotic division to form the sporogenous tissue. The last generation of the sporogenous tissue function as microspore mother cell. This microspore mother cell, each microspore mother cell divides meiotically. Here only meiotic division starts, meiotically, and form a tetra of four haploid microspores. and the latter separate each other and it will become a pollen grain. See here, the separated pollen grains are here. In some plants, the cells of microspores in a microsporangium remains held together. If you see here, all the microspores, that is pollen grains, are held together and called pollinium. Once again, I'll tell you, in some plants, all the microspores, that is the pollen grains, are held together and called pollinium. The best example is the Calotropis, that is in Tamil, it is called Erukanjedi. You see here, the pollen grains are free. In that picture, I showed you the picture. But here, all the pollen grains, that is the microspores, are held together. The whole structure is called the pollinium. The pollinia are attached to a clamp or clip-like structure that is called corpusculum. The filamentous thread-like structure arising from each pollinium is called retinaculum. You see here, this filamentous structure is called retinaculum. The whole structure look like a inverted Y-shaped structure, that is called translator. The whole structure is looking like inverted Y shape. This is called translator. See here, it is clearly shown here. And see this picture. Retinaculum is given here. This is the pollinium. See the Y shaped structure, inverted Y shaped structure. Is it clear for you? Students, today we have seen the development of anther. In the next video class, I will explain you the transverse section of anther. I hope this will be very helpful for you, for your examination point of view. Thank you, students.